The day after I just shot that blizzard video, I gotta see what it looks like. Somebody did our driveway for us. Okay, so I'll have to clear this out. They cleared this out. So they must have come in here with a scoop. I gotta move my car. So I gotta clear this out.
Everything you thought was good was really bad. Everything bad was really good.
What if heaven was on earth?
The whole world, vice versa. Vice versa.
Hell, don't try to get it.
This shit here, goddamn, gonna get you a motherfucking fat ass running that drone. Smoke that shit.
It's all vice versa.
Look up in the air, nigga.
You guys cleared this area out for us?
Huh?
You guys cleared that out?
I did all that.
Did you use a bucket or the blower room attachment?
I used my blower. I spent 2 hours on the other end blowing everything off the sidewalk.
It's crazy, right?
Yeah.
You guys
can't. Legally, I can't.
You can't?
No.
Would you be able to? I can. Where you at? Well, my car's not running right. If I can make it out there.
It's just right there. That black
equinox. Let's do it.
Where?
There you go.
There you go.
All right, it's giving the neighbor a jump. Now I gotta go head out to this interview. All right, so let's talk a little bit about what's gonna happen here. This is what I predict is gonna happen. For people that don't know, I'm a nurse. I've been a nurse for over a year now. When I first got to Wilmer in 1999, I got my first degree in drug counseling, got my associates, didn't do nothing with it, was enjoying my life for several years. And I went back to school, not too long ago actually, because I just graduated in May of last year. But anyway, so I'm a nurse now, and enjoy my job, pays all right. And I'm gonna go see if I can get another second job at the college. That's a state job. Those are usually pretty good, but I think it's gonna be so part-time that there's no benefits. And really the best part about working for the state is the benefits. So if there's no benefits, and now they're talking about really part-time, like maybe 20 hours per pay period or something like that. And I did the math and I see what they wanna pay me. They wanna pay me the minimum. On the state's website, it said minimum of $16.95 or something or other, with a maximum of $23.90 something or other. So that's the scale. But when I talked to Lynn Johnson, the dean there of the nursing program, she was telling me that they're gonna bring me in at the bare minimum. And I don't know about you, but me in my life, I like to go up in my life. I never wanna come down. You wanna keep just going up, up, up and up, right? No one wants to go down. So if they're gonna offer me less than 20, I can't take it. It'd just be hustling backwards. Because I'm getting to a point where my time is really valuable. The projects and endeavors that I'm involved in are more beneficial to me in the long run than this short-term cash. I did the math. I think per month I can pull in like an extra $400 to $500 a month, maybe. Now that might be good for some of you, but that's not enough for my time. Because I work every day except Tuesdays, so it's not like I'm got time just to be giving away and also to all my projects take time to develop, to edit, to process and all that. And I value my time, so $17 an hour is not worth my time. As crazy as that might seem, and some people probably think I'm dumb, it's not. And you know what? The things I do on the side don't even pay. They don't pay right now. It doesn't mean that they can't pay in the future, but you have to have that mentality. Otherwise, you'll never really get ahead, because as long as you're exchanging time for money, you'll never get ahead, because there's only so many hours in a day. There's even so many hours in a day that you can be working. So it's just slavery. The reality is, to get ahead is you have to establish businesses, some sort of business setup where you can make money when you're not working, that passive income. And you have to be creative on how you solve that problem. And it's up to each and one, every one of us, to figure it out. What's our lane? Where do we fit in? Sometimes you have to build your lane so that you can be riding safe, riding comfortably in your lane. So we're gonna go out to Ridgewater College right now. My appointment was for 2. I guess I'm already late. So if they see me, they see me. If they don't, they don't. I don't know how well the camera in their face is gonna go, but I'm gonna bring it anyways.
Second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she is waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken.
I'm at my alma mater. I'm a 2-time alumni from this place. My first degree was in 2002. It's Associates in Chemical Dependency Counseling. Then I got my diploma, which allowed me to get licensed as a nurse. So I should see it. They should be rolling out the red carpet for me. Yeah, I'm trying to go get my 3rd degree it'll be for the RN, so it's a higher level up in nursing. But hi, Lynn.
Hi, Robert.
I made it. Good.
What are you doing?
Vlogging. It's a new thing. All the kids are doing it now.
Oh, so you're vlogging. You better be careful here. They have to sign waivers to photograph. Yeah.
For photograph? What about for video? Yeah, I was wondering about what the policy is.
So you walk around
filming my life? And you probably ask, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people ask themselves, like, what's so interesting about your life than everybody else's life? And really, there isn't. It's just that, you know. And also too, I like to chronicle my life so I can go back and I can see what I did. And
well, I've seen it on the travel shows.
Yeah, so I got some travel vlogs, but usually it's just like life. How's it going?
We're gonna go this way here. We might have to ask that you shut that off.
Yeah, no problem. 17 to 23, and I was like, okay, put me in the middle, I'm fine. But it's never like that. Well, guys, thank you for your time.
Okay, Lynn,
Terrence, Jeannie, my own instructor, Jeannie. I'm going to get a kick out of it. All right, guys, you have a good day. Have a good night.
Thank you.
Yeah, go out this way. See? All right, so this is Ridge. It's probably a view most people don't get. This is kind of services area, but this is the ag building. That over there is the science building. Hello. And I think these are like financial aid assistance. Cool. Yeah, I've been back here before, so I'm getting towards the front of the desk here, and I'll see my way out this way. There's the desk. All right. Yeah, it went down kind of like I expected. Told them I need that 20 twin twin. You guys want to see the cafeteria?
Hold on. What? Let me catch my breath.
Yeah.
Let me count these checks.
What?
flex on my ex.
Yeah.
I don't got no respect.
I don't.
Break up in a text.
What?
Pull up in a G.
Yeah.
T3 fly off in a jet. Pull up, I'm suited.
Yeah.
And you know I got my tool. Okay, I might Bentley Cooper.
What?
Heard you pull up Mini Cooper.
Yeah.
Told that little bitch that she stupid. Okay, these niggas can't move me.
What?
Okay, these bitches can't move me. Those are not diamonds, they're rubies. Wait, that's not rubies, that's glass.
Well, like, it wasn't a waste of time because now they understand how I value myself, and they'll probably consider me if there ever is a position that I probably fit in, and I'm building relationships, so it's not a complete loss or a waste of time. I got out this good video for you. You see me, how kind of what it looks like to plow. They kind of did the hardest part with the housing people. Did a great job at cleaning out the driveway there, but you kind of get an idea what that looks like. And you got an idea of what it's like to be at Ridgewater. And if you guys are interested in seeing more of the college, I can come and give you a full tour. So if you're interested in something like that, let me know by leaving a like, a comment, and for sure, subscribing. You probably wonder, why should I subscribe? Well, I'm gonna tell you why. Because you don't see it now, but the value that I'm bringing is a value that nobody else is bringing. Since you guys made it all the way to the end, I'm gonna add a little bonus. I'm here at the Peps Barbershop and Relentless Tattoos, where it's gonna be changing to the new location. But I don't know how much battery I have left, but let's talk to David.
It's me.
Yeah, I know.
That's nice. It's coming out nice. That's nice. I hope you guys don't mind. Oh, you're in the middle of a deep one here. Yeah, I am.
Oh, are you actually?
Yeah, yeah. My information.
I just got one.
Did you? Oh, so it's like a.
I can almost.
We twins?
Are we twins?
Kind of like. You kind of look alike.
Are we?
You think so?
That's no, you're not.
No.
Which I could pass as twins.
We're roommates.
Okay.
Yeah.
For college?
Yep.
What are you going for?
Ridgewater. We're going for vet tech.
I just came from Ridge. I was trying to apply for the nursing lab assistant.
Really?
Yeah, I'm a nurse, and so a nurse has to do that job, but they don't pay enough, so. You guys want to be in it? Say something.
Yes.
Tell them where you're from and what you're going for. And...
I'm from Staples, Minnesota. My name's Cameron.
My name's Kieran Michael, and I'm from Staples also.
Staples? How far is that? Is that south?
2 hours. Wow.
2 hours
up north.
North?
Yeah.
You're in Bear Country.
Yeah.
I've been to Huntersville, which is about 2 hours north.
I go to Huntersville for a huge party festival every year.
By the river?
Yep.
Yeah, we did. I have been there too. I've been down floating and stuff.
Yep. And it's fun.
Yeah, it's a trip. It's different. Yeah. What's the population? Like Wilmer size?
Nope.
No. Not
really?
No. What is it? Like 4,000?
I think it's less than that.
Really? Because I've heard that name before and it just seemed like a big town.
No, we have a train station there and like there's a motel there. But that's new.
Hell yeah.
Let's go, it's Rage.
2,955.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
You know what? I used to party with the vet tech my first time in college back in 1999. So they get down over at what Evergreen was the place back then.
Yeah, we live in Fairview, by Evergreen.
Yeah, so it's either Fairview, Evergreen, or Lee.
Jenny Lee,
because back then the farm kids were in Jenny Lee, but now they kind of get houses in the area. That's a better setup.
Mm-hmm. Now Jenny Lee is all girls.
Is it?
Yeah, it's and you can't
no
you
farming.
Can have a dog there.
But they're really like conservative there, is
yeah.
That? Yeah, you're in a good spot.
All the parties are in Evergreen.
But they get busted every time.
Yeah,
it's just the way it works.
Yeah,
it's just the way it is.
Yeah.
It's because the kids are too loud, man. They don't know how to like chill. They just want to rowdy. They just want to turn
up.
That's
the party.
And you know what it is? It's the hormones are so strong. You guys have to be like, man, fuck that. Woo! Ah! They all fall. You know what I mean? Like,
actually, I'm not going to lie. That happened
Like,
yeah, I know, because I used to party with you guys. You know, I know exactly what's going on. And it's a mess, because everybody's always trying to compete, and guys are always trying to show off, so of course we're doing stunts.
For the wrestling, shotgunning beers in like so many seconds.
Yeah, it's a hot mess. All right, guys, that's about as much as I'm going to show you of the tattooing with David, a.k.a. Baby Ink, a.k.a. Baby Beats, a.k.a. Paradise Ink, a.k.a. Street Tattoos, a.k.a. Come out, David, I'm missing one. So this guy had all these, like, growing up. Y'all don't know him from the very Baller's Paradise era, huh?
I'm trying not to laugh.
All right, so thank you for joining me once again. If you like this type of content, as always, like the content, and remember to
like and subscribe.
Follow up on the progress on the shop. I don't think anybody's here. Well. Got the wiring going on. Got the... So they're doing the wiring. Kind of excited for this place to be done. So that's kind of a quick tour of what it looks like at this point. And it's rough, but I can see the vision already. I can see it coming together. All right, so just a quick update of the shop. If you don't know where it's at, it's directly in front of the VFW. It's not set to open until March, I think mid-March, but I'll let you know as that starts to develop.